Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about prefix sum arrays and how to answer range sum queries really fast. Imagine you're given an array of integers and a lot of queries asking you what would be the sum of all the integers in the given range. How could you answer those types of queries as fast as possible? Let's look at an example. Say we upload this video to YouTube and would like to know how well it performed on any given date range. Let's imagine that on the day of uploading the video, it got 8 likes, so we add 8 to day 0. On the next day, 3 people liked it, and the day after, 2 people liked it and 4 people disliked it, so we subtract 2 from the score, and so on. So, for any given date, the score of the video is the number of likes minus the number of dislikes the video got on that particular day. And now we would like to know how well the video performed from day 2 to day 7 or from day 3 to day 6, and we would like to answer those types of queries as fast as possible. Well, the naive approach would be to iterate over all the days in the given range and sum those numbers together, right? So if the query asks, how well did the video perform from day 2 to day 7, we would start from day 2, then move to the score of day 3, then 2, 4, up until day 7, and sum those values together. If we're asked to calculate the video performance from day 3 to day 6, we would start from the day 3 and then move to day 4, then to 5, then finally to 6 and sum those values together. But this approach is very slow and requires performing a lot of redundant operations. So, to come up with an algorithm that can answer these queries faster, let's first simplify the problem a little bit. So, imagine that all the queries ask what would be the video performance starting from the first day. So, in other words, what would be the sum of all the numbers starting from the day 0 up until the query day? This is a little bit easier to answer, and we'll soon see that there is only one extra step required to answer any kind of range queries if we can answer this one quickly enough. Imagine there are many queries asking you what is the sum of all the numbers from day 0 up until the query day. Again, let's look at the naive approach. If the queries ask you about the performance up until days 3, 5, 2, and 7, we can loop through all the numbers for each of the queries and add the values in our initial array together. So for 3, we would calculate A0 plus A1 plus A2 plus A3. Then for 5, we would calculate A0 plus A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4 plus A5. For 2, we would sum up A0, A1, and A2. While for 7, we would need to add all the numbers from A0 up until A7. Notice how the first part of the computation is always the same. Before calculating the result for 5, we already knew the result for day 3. Before calculating the result for day 7, we already knew the result for day 5. So, there's definitely some room to optimize this. To do that, let's calculate the performance result for all the days starting from day 0 up until the last day available. Let's call the resulting sum P, which stands for the prefix sum. So, each element of P would represent the sum up until that day. So, answering a question like, what is the result of the video performance up until day 7? We can just print the value stored in P at location 7. So, let's calculate the array P. The first element of P is equal to the first element of the given array. The second is the sum of the first 2 elements. The third is the sum of the first 3, and so on up until the last element of the array. Did you notice the pattern? To calculate the next element in the prefix sum array, we repeat all the actions in the previous one and then add only one more element from the initial array. Well, as all the actions are already stored in the previous element of the prefix sum array, we can just reuse it. So the prefix sum array can be calculated with a single for loop. We can initialize the first element of P to be equal to the first element of A, and then for all the next elements from 1 to n, the elements of P will be equal to the sum of the previous element and the corresponding value in the array A. Now, if anyone asks, how was the performance of the video up until day 6, we can just print P6. Or if they ask what was the performance of the video up until day 8, we can just print P8. So we pre-computed some values which took us n operations, and now we can answer any query with only one operation. Now let's go back to the initial question of obtaining the video performance for a range of days. So given many queries of the form from L to R, we would like to know how the video scored starting from day L up until day R. You can pause the video and think for a little bit to come up with the final answer yourself. If we know the performance of a video from the time it was uploaded up until some day X by just accessing an element from the prefix sum array P of X, then we can get its performance up until day R and get its performance before day L and subtract those two values. So the sum of any range from L to R would just be P of R minus P of L minus 1. But wait, as you can notice, when we subtract P of L minus 1 from P of R, if L is 0, L minus 1 can get negative, right? There are two ways of handling this. You can write a separate if statement for that case when L is 0, or a more elegant solution would be to add an additional 0 at the beginning of the arrays. This will make sure that we don't hit a case where L is 0. So we need to update our calculations and get the answer by subtracting P of L from P of R plus 1. So implementing this would look something like the following. This small trick helps eliminate some if-else conditions and have a clean and concise code. Oh, by the way, you can get some hands-on practice with prefix sum arrays by going to Profound Academy and solving several problems using the technique we just learned. Link is in the description below. Now let's see the algorithm in action. First, we calculate the prefix sum array with the initial element being 0. Afterwards, each element is equal to the sum of its previous value and corresponding element in the initial array. Now we can answer any query with only a single operation. To know the sum of elements from the second position to the fourth one, we can just subtract P of 5 from P of 2. To know the sum of the range from 5 to 8, we can subtract P of 5 from P of 9. Even the ranges including 0 are perfectly handled, and getting one element as well. As we add 1 to the right border, we can safely calculate the value of a single element using the prefix sum array. So getting the value for any range is just a single operation of subtracting two values, and therefore we can answer each query in all of one time. In total, if we have n items in our array and q queries, we would perform n operations to get the array, pre-compute the prefix summary, and q operations to answer all the queries. So in total, the time complexity of the algorithm would be O of n plus q, while the memory complexity would be O of n as we hold the initial array and also create a new one that has a length of n plus 1. This was it for prefix sum arrays. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.